God gives gifts to all Christians, spiritual gifts. He gives one or more to every Christian, all to be used for the good of the body of Christ. It's not something we can ask for. It's not something we can trade. Let's read what Paul writes about these gifts in 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verses 4 to 7. There are different kinds of gifts, but the same Spirit distributes them. There are different kinds of service, but the same Lord. There are different kinds of working, but in all of them and in everyone, it is the same God at work. Now to each one, the manifestation of the Spirit is given for the common good. Paul is reminding Christians that there are different gifts. No one has all of them, but all Christians have at least one. These aren't gifts that are just given to people who are more special or important than others. But he also reminds believers that all the gifts come from the same source, the Holy Spirit, and they are all intended for the common good. Let's read some of the gifts he lists. We'll continue with verses 8 to 12. To one, there is given through the Spirit a message of wisdom. To another, a message of knowledge by means of the same Spirit. To another, faith by the same Spirit. To another, gifts of healing by that one Spirit. To another, miraculous powers. To another, prophecy. To another, distinguishing between spirits. To another, speaking in different kinds of tongues. And to still another, the interpretation of tongues. All these are the work of one and the same Spirit, and he distributes them to each one, just as he determines. Just as a body, though one, has many parts, but all its many parts form one body, so it is with Christ. Here, Paul lists the gifts of wisdom, knowledge, faith, healing, prophecy, distinguishing between spirits, and the gift of tongues. There are more gifts. These are just a few. Then he reminds us that they all come from the same Holy Spirit. Paul talks about our gifts working together like the part of a body. When each part does what it was created to do, then the body as a whole works at its maximum capacity. That's how it is for the church too. Let's read a bit more of Paul's teaching in 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verses 27 to 31. Now you are the body of Christ, and each one of you is a part of it. And God has placed in the church, first of all, apostles, second, prophets, third, teachers, then miracles, then gifts of healing, of helping, of guidance, and of different kinds of tongues. Are all apostles? Are all prophets? Are all teachers? Do all work miracles? Do all have gifts of healing? Do all speak in tongues? Do all interpret? Now eagerly desire the greater gifts. And yet I will show you the most excellent way. No one person is the whole body. No one person has all the gifts the church needs. Paul says to desire the greater gifts. Does that mean some are better than others? No. In this context, he's encouraging people to desire what he listed first. These are gifts that deal the most directly with the good news about Jesus and sharing it with others. Spiritual gifts are always about benefiting everyone, not about having a better gift than someone else. You'll be taking a spiritual gifts inventory to help you discover what gifts God may have given you. This is just a tool to start the journey. God may be developing something else in you, or you may learn that you didn't answer the questions as honestly as you first thought, and you have different spiritual gifts than what this tool says. Remember, God always gets the final say on the matter. Paul finished his teaching on spiritual gifts in this passage by saying that he's now going to teach on the most excellent way. That's how 1 Corinthians 12 ends. And then he begins in the next chapter to teach on love. No matter what gifts we discover we've been given, the important truths are to remember that they all come from the Holy Spirit to be used for the benefit of others, and that love is the most important motive for seeking to know and use our gifts.